2017. Hard lessons, but lessons needed. I was born to a hardworking family, a dog-loving family, and I started living on my own since I was 16. I brought along my husky, who my mom adopted from the pound, and I soon adopted Cypher from ARF. In my early 20s, I started Dog Essentials Daycare in Marteloup, and that went amazing. However, it did go with my relationship at that time, so it wasn't my first failed business. I make one good decision in my life, and I married the man of my dreams, who loves dogs just as much as I did. And we made a vow together to give our dogs the best life we possibly could. And who knew that it would be in a dog business? We adopted Mimi together from ARF, and we watched our senior girl JJ age, and we learned about nutrition, the importance of food, and the importance of trusting your vet during this difficult time. With heartache comes knowledge, comes lessons, and we made sure to pass on all that we learned into our newest addition in 2009, which is Shogun. He opened our eyes to the bully breed and is a main reason why Sleep Rover allows all breeds of dogs. We don't discriminate and there's no need to. With researching, training, understanding, we soon realized that we were able to set up an amazing business where we all didn't discriminate, where we all can help out where we can, and thus Sleep Rover was created. And Megan and Amanda have been a part of our family since the beginning. Thor came into our life at the highlight of our life. It was 2013, and he represented the joy, the happiness, the success of the business. And we traveled more, we took them everywhere, we even started vlogging about all our travels with our dogs and encouraged our friends and clients to bring their dogs everywhere with them. It soon ended tragically when we found Thor had passed on our way back from Seattle. And I will never forget the screams that Jimmy and I made at the 24-hour truck stop when we found him, cuddled up to Bourbon. Should we have not traveled, should we have not done all this, he would still be alive. But he lived the most fulfilled life that I know. This quote says it best: when you can tell your story, it doesn't make you cry. You know you have healed. And although I haven't fully healed, Benjamin came into our life to bring joy back into our life. And Benjamin was my reminder of what is important in life, and that is life itself. I can complain about my corrupt realtor, I can complain about my dishonest landlord, I can complain about everything, but at the end of the day, it's poor planning. I took on too much, and my clients, the girls of Sleep, to spending a year with the lawyers, to maxing out all my loans, I was digging my hole deeper and deeper and deeper, and I was at the point where I actually decided that selling Sleep Rover would be the best option. But that's just the easy way, and winners don't give up. And with all your support, I can't give up. With all the girls' support, I can't give up. We took Benjamin's last trip in May, and it taught me many lessons. Especially thinking that I was low back then, to realize I was actually at my lowest, my rock bottom. And you can read about it on my blog. When you hit rock bottom, if you want to survive, you realize you have to get back to the basics, the foundation of Sleep Rover, who are the caregivers, the ones that started from the beginning. Focus on the clients, focus on the care, and forget all the frilly. Just forget all the fancy things and just be who you are and stay within your means. With the rate increases last year, you guys helped us get us out of the hole. And 2018, our goal is, again, to be able to provide the services with the barriers that we face with minimum wage and utilities. And we know we can do it, and we want to be able to give back to all of you. And that is our goal for 2018. Thank you for everything.